I'm Sir Tap-Tap, and let's play Grand Kingdom. This is a game for PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita by Nippon Ichi Software. Every cup of games provided by the publisher. So this is a strategy RPG with some online elements. We're actually going to be playing the online mode, unlike how I usually do things. The game has some real-time mechanics and stuff that sort of might remind you of free-to-play stuff. It's not a free-to-play game, and it has some of the pluses of free-to-play stuff, but not the minuses. And what I mean by that is when we go into this war menu here, so we create these squads of four people, and I actually need to recall my squad so I can actually play the game. You can send your squads out on missions, and they'll fight for you, and they lost. So you have these sets of up to four people, and you can have up to six squads, and you can just send them to fight on their own, but there's no... What I mean by no bad free-to-play stuff is there's no penalty if they lose or anything. You just don't get as much stuff. Wait, I actually need to go back into war. You only get benefits. You never get penalized or, like, lose permanent stuff. Because you... Everybody's attacking us! What the heck? Well, I guess I will go and invade, so there's four nations in this game. I guess I should show you that. There we go. So there's four nations in this game, and the game's like, you're these mercenaries, and everything is about war. And you conscript to, different nations to, see here, I'm part of the blue nation in the bottom right corner there. We're the largest one, but, this green and, well, actually all the nations are doing pretty well right now. Except for red. Red got stomped. Whew. Green, for some reason, is our enemy. I'm not entirely sure why, but we hate green is feel. So, I usually go after feel. A few weeks ago, they just took up a whole crap ton of our land, even though they had very few, like, relatively less people than us. They just won all of the wars, and so we've just sort of had a rivalry with them ever since. It's kind of interesting. I haven't talked with the other people playing this game, but we just sort of have a communal rivalry with Feel, just because they took our stuff, I guess. There's also some flavor for each of the nations, and I guess Feel is sort of the opposite of Landereth. Landereth is like the generic. It's America. It's the big nation. It's got a lot of resources and stuff. Ooh, dang. I guess I'll go ahead and hire this. So when you go into war, we are actually going to be fighting NPCs based on real people's characters. Like real people's squads and stuff. Huh. And when we go into this, we can actually hire up to two little mercenaries to help us out here. And we actually want to do that every time because those mercenaries auto-heal and we don't have to worry about them getting knocked out. And we'll only fight up to four enemies. Yeah. So as you'll see here, I have six people, and they'll have a maximum of four, so we're at a pretty significant advantage if we do the, good old, level 35, wait, I forget what level I am, I think that's higher than me. One frustration I have with the online mode in this game is, maybe it's because I hired a level 32? I want to take down a leader? If we take down a leader, we demoralize the crew, and they get a stat debuff. I think I'm gonna go for it. My black here is crazy strong. Oh, dang! Okay. A little bit overkill there. Yeah, one complaint I do have... I think I can... There you go. Oh, man. My blacksmith is so overpowered. So, when you charge up that meter at the top right there, or top left, you get assists, and she just does insane damage for assists. So, like, if I take down, like, half of somebody's HP... Holy crap! What was that? Oh, this jackass. If I take out even half of somebody's HP, I will usually be able to one-hit KO them. Well, again, I'll be able to KO them with the assist. So... Damn, that is so annoying. See, I'm doing incredibly well, but I took a ton of damage here because of this jerk. I'm gonna hit him for a minute. So, it's like a mini, it's one of those games that's like a mini SRPG where it's, you know, a small crew, but we, can I slide in here? I can't? Ah, crap, I didn't think this through. I need to heal my friend here, but I can't reach her to throw a healing item at her, so... Ah, damn it. That's not gonna work out either. Maybe this. Like I said before, I don't have to worry about hurting this guy. Because he's just, you know, he'll be auto-healed at the end of combat. Unfortunately, it is a problem that my assassin, or my rogue over there took some damage. Now that area's gonna take damage. So this is a pretty standard battle. Unfortunately, I'm fighting an enemy that's pretty dang high level, but it wasn't a problem because my team was faster and we just destroyed them, basically. See? Oh, she's so good. That ground knock seems to do double damage for assists or something. It just always does crazy damage. But my blacksmith's really good. I always use her. Oh, I am level 37. Okay. Sorry about that. I'm just used to my team being underleveled. So when you level up, you can choose which of your stats you want to focus on, basically, by assigning these stars. The higher these stars are in each category, you know, strength, more physical damage resistance. I usually go for tech, which means you level up faster. I believe level 99 is the max, like it usually is. And I just wasn't sure. Restore HP. Survival drops, I guess. You get more benefits if you do success in battles, and this next enemy is level 13, so we're probably gonna wipe the floor with them. Damage is kind of flat, so level 13, I mean, they're not gonna be dealing zero damage, but they're gonna be, you know, I'm gonna have a pretty easy time taking them out. Unfortunately, he's just out of my range, so I can only deal about half of his health. Oops. That was so hard. Yes, individual battles are a lot like a little mini SRPG. I rather like battles like this because, oh, crap. So this thing in my way is an explosive barrel. It'll hurt all of us if I take him, if I take it out. Such a pain in the butt. And unfortunately, we can't move through guarding units, which is actually... My sword zone up there is actually in the way. So there's 17 different classes in this game. See, look how little damage he does. They have a possibility of defeating me if, like, they had really good units, but, and, like, really good strategy, but since they're AI, pretty low chance that they would actually beat me this way. So I actually have to be really careful with how I throw this, because you can't hit your friend in the head. Aw, damn it. Just not quite enough. You can actually hit your friend, and then, aw, damn it. Oh. Didn't do enough to hurt anyway. Ah! So they got the heal off. The healer is one of the more important units because I've only seen two characters heal. The medic obviously has some healing stuff. There's also the gunner can heal you with bullets. Not sure how that works, but ah! Come on! I just got fired on before that guy even had a turn. So one of the things in these major battles is you have these armaments that'll give you supporting fire in every battle that takes place within that range. I'm gonna try to take down that healer. And so the combat is not quite like Mario Party, but it has this slight bit of action to it that lets you pick exactly. Oh! I didn't realize this guy was alive. I think I can KO you. Aw, no! He's just out of range. That sucks. Take out that healer. Leaders are generally who you want to target first, but healers are also pretty good to target. Oop. I'm not sure why that exploded. I'm unfortunately not really familiar with a lot of the classes that I don't use. I don't use the spears often, I don't use the bows often. This is pretty much my main crew. Just get a little closer. I don't want to hurt my mobile there. Aw, crap. Yeah, you deal about 30 damage if you knock somebody into somebody else. It's not a big... Oh, that's one of mine. Oh. I'm just so not used to seeing that unit. I just... That completely... Sorry about that, mercenary guy. It's okay. He's a mercenary. He's good. He's paid to die for my amusement. So, apparently, if you do enough successive battles in a row, we'll actually see a, called it a national hero, so like I think it's just one of the best player characters on the enemy team. So let's just do a successive battle. So as you can see, the levels vary quite widely. That's probably my main complaint of the online mode. Oh, everybody loves those barrels. I don't tend to use the interruption things because my team is almost all melee, so I just focus on getting all the way. Oh. Yeah, and they can set up traps like that. Can't really do anything. I do wish my team had a bit more capability to buff and stuff, because I do kind of end up with these wasted turns where I can't really do much of anything, because there's an obstruction in the way. But melee is really satisfying, and it works, so... Yeah, guard depends... Your amount of health your guard has depends on how much action gauge you had left, so if all I do is guard on a turn, I'll have an insane amount of guard. So, that guy had basically no chance of actually getting through my guard. This is just advance. This is why it's good to have some ranged units, because I can't really attack except for with the archer that I hired, and to a lesser extent my medic, who doesn't deal much damage. I do have a couple teams that are more focused on dealing damage from a range, but... I don't tend to use those. I'm just not as good with them, and they feel they're more squishy. They're more situational. This just works, especially for single. I mostly build for single player, really. Also, when somebody's charging like that, you can interrupt their charge by dealing enough damage. Oz is gonna be good. Oh, I love her assists. Look at that, almost 400 damage. That is a lot. That is like a one-hit KO on a character of about level 20, I think. So it's about half of the HP of any character in my current level. Sorry, buddy. I think the mercenaries just respawn with full HP outside of the battle. We do have to watch our health. We don't get fully healed after a battle. We have to use items and stuff. Or we get KO'd and then we'll have a brief waiting period and then heal. Touch my nose. So, when I said it's kind of like Paper Mario, it's like, you know, you have these, as you can see, there's some active, you choose which moves to attack, and then you sort of choose exactly when to cancel out of your moves. Ah, this freaking guy! So this guy has, I guess he has an attack that attacks the column below, or the row below him as well, which I am not used to, and that's kind of annoying. So you can build combos with basically any melee attack, as long as you can't combo the same attack into itself, but otherwise you can build your own combos, and that's pretty cool. You have to make sure you don't knock the opponent out of the way of your range, though. Yep, we got it! Except it looks like we lost at least one, too. So once you're out of battle, the map updates, and you're basically just trying to knock down all their forts while keeping all of your forts. Predictable stuff. I think we are still winning. You can skip this animation. And if you keep your forts longer, they strengthen like this. We can also take down their armaments. I usually don't bother. I'm not a super pro at the online portion of this game. I mostly play the single player. This game's not online only. You can play it offline, but you will be missing, like, some of the shops that have the better items. You get paid in this, so there's two currencies. It's not quite,
It doesn't matter how
much. Oops. Excuse me. I forgot to check about the status. I think we're slightly winning. Or winning somewhat, at least. There's two currencies, but it's not quite F2P style stuff. Oh, he didn't heal. I thought they did heal. Ah, whatever. I don't care. I'm fine. The second currency, like usual in these online things, the online mode is the way you get the better currency, and you get more of the regular money through easier offline stuff. You do get royals, which is the, you know, better currency. She's got surprising reach with two of her attacks, Crash Sword and I think Fast Hack. So even when they look out of range like she did there, I can actually deal quite a bit of hurt. Oh, for God's sakes, you jack! Oops. Okay, so that was a little bad. I never want to hire a spearman again. That attacking out of range is really annoying. I'm sure I could, you know, account for it with my attacks, but I never use that, so I'm not used to it. Used to using them.
Wow, I look so strong.
But every time you send out your units, like you saw at the beginning of the game, you can send out your units to, you know, get free money by, you know, fighting in real time. Those units actually go out and then they fight people that are playing online like this. We're always fighting against, you know, NPCs, but they're actually other players' characters. Oh, we're not doing well at all. What happened? And they're all noobs. Why are they all so bad? Well, 13 isn't complete noob, but, I think I'm halfway or maybe a bit more than halfway through the story, and I'm level 30-some? 35. What? What? That always connects! What was that? I'm awestruck. Armor break and then ground knock always works for me. I've never seen that fail. Here. Annoying guy's turn. I should have hired. I just went for the two highest. Fender Guard. Decrease damage. Huh. Okay. Yeah, I'm not used to his skills at all. Oh, look at his pretty bow! Aw, isn't that cute? He has two identical people. Holy crap! That is rude! That is freaking rude! So, since her guard broke, I can actually use that opportunity to go ahead and attack, you know, walk through her and pummel that person. I have an auto guard skill on. You can actually turn that off so that they won't block, which makes them able to take a bit more damage, but also means I can more easily wander through my own units to, you know, get a good hit off. Should hit. If you're too close, you will actually throw that arced item directly into the back of the person in front of you, which is pretty funny. It's actually kind of useful when you're throwing a healing item, because then you can throw it to somebody too close to you. Oh, this guy! He moves just slow enough that he gets hit by the artillery every time, and yeah, he's dead. The stats you get for characters are somewhat random. You can, there's an interface where you recruit people. I just can't do anything with her, unfortunately. So sometimes a unit for one class will be incredibly fast, and sometimes it'll be pretty slow. So Hard Slash that I just did there has a lot of knockback. I usually don't use it, but it's a good finisher. This game also has two combo modes where you can... The Spearman has, you can just mash circle, you know, it's a simplified mode, very easy to use, but it reduces your ability to strategize, so I don't do that. Let's just do successive battles. So individually I'm doing really well here, but my team is not. I will not actually be particularly penalized. Like, I don't lose anything if my team loses. Like, my team does technically lose, you know, we can potentially lose this section of the map. But then, you know, next war, which I think a war is just a day, basically. Next war. Aw, you jackasses! I hate these trap people so much. For God's sake. At least I lowered his guard. Oh, and she's in the wrong spot. You can change your starting formation, as you see. The enemies usually have different starting formations than me. She's actually a bit too far back, which is why I can't always get her to the action. There's a great deal of different skills characters can learn, and if I hit him, aw, crap, I can't. So that guy there has an attack that poisons just from a normal attack, so that's very nice. You can actually attack people out of your row. I can attack down here, but I would hit my own unit. I'm not close enough to hit that spear guy. So I actually have nothing useful for this character to do. Unfortunately, she does not go first. She has the longest range, like run movement range. So I really wish I could send her out first. Don't hit him. Aw, crap. That's what I mean by accidentally hitting the person in the back of the head. I thought it was far enough. It doesn't actually show in the arc whether you will hit the person in front of you, so it's kind of annoying. You just have to do that, you know, you just have to memorize that. Ugh, annoying. So a lot of skills or characters have these area denial skills. Oh, he didn't even break the guard! What a wuss. Okay, let's get this guy out of range of fire for once. Kind of fun juggling people. The more there's a stat, I think it's agility, that gives you more actions per turn. Basically, it lets that attack bar fill further each turn. I'm so surprised that guy didn't die. Your characters will revive with 1 HP if they get KO'd, so there's no dying. You never lose any units. There's no negative penalties other than basically buying things is the only way you ever lose anything. And that's all within your control. The game never takes anything from you because you suck. You just don't win as much stuff, which is why I like it, even though I usually don't like the online competitive-y stuff. Yeah, thank you. So I really like that my noble here and my blacksmith down there with the hammer have these attacks that let them armor break. And so I always lead in with the armor break, and then I hit him with my strongest attack, and then I just continue with normal, weaker combos. Very effective. My rogue here has two attacks that actually deal extra damage to leaders. Unfortunately, one of my extra damage to leader skills knocks them back farther, which is why I couldn't get that last hit on there. But I was dealing 30% extra damage, so it's sort of a trade-off. Probably give you more tech. See, I think she's behind in level. Well, I actually use her a little less. I always use my my blacksmith because she's so good. I actually just got her totally randomly. I did not think of what I was doing. I just recruited one of every single unit, which I do recommend, by the way. Yeah, Operation End. We lost that. Ah, feels sucks. So, I think a bunch of higher level characters started picking Feel after, Landorath is like the default, basically. The cursor starts on Landorath, and its description is that it's, you know, a big place, so I'm pretty sure a lot of newbies pick Landorath. I mean, I did when I was a newbie. So I think that may be why we don't do as well relative to our amount of people, but Feel has a lot of people now, too. Magion has been doing really well. I'm not entirely sure. Oh yeah, this gives you little hints. Every time you come back, you get a hint, you get an update for the overall war, you know, between all the nations. The war is basically all the online stuff. Another aspect, sort of free-to-play-like, we get these objectives, and we get these policy points which let us buff whether we get more experience, more gold, and more royals, which are the second currency. I hope I'm not scaring you too much with all the free-to-play talk. I was worried about that too, but it's not bad stuff. It keeps the good stuff with none of the, well, not too much of the bad. There's a little There is some stuff you can buy with real money, but it's actually not. It's just upgrade your people, like, to train them. But, I don't think you can buy money directly. Oh, there's a... Oh my gosh! Aw, oh, she has Matt. Well, I might have to recruit her. Troop attack up. So, the dragon mages are basically two units in one, and they take up two unit slots. But they have basically double the health of a normal unit. They have both physical and magical attacks. They are huge. They have great attacks. There's very good units, just offset by the fact that, you know, you lose a unit slot. And your other units are basically going to be supporting them, so if you have one of them, it basically determines your entire strategy. You know, you're going to have to build your entire team around them, which has its ups and downs. Oh, troop attack is really good. So the character stats are almost completely random. I think my action for her is low just because she was a dragon? I think weight is like your speed, and act is how much your bar fills, I think. I'm actually not 100% sure on that. But your field skill and ability are actually also random. So, you can get some real weird characters or very good characters in the higher member. You just kind of have to check it every operation. Oh, also one other thing I don't entirely like. I'm gonna hire her. So I guess we can see the character select here. Let's see what colors we got here. Like, it's so big that she doesn't fit. The dragon doesn't fit. I already have Dragon Girl with the black dress, so I won't pick that one. Very, very purple. Kind of like that green one. I kind of like that red and that. The purple's almost Spyro. But you name the character, not this. You name the girl, not the dragon. And almost every class has a male and a female option. A few are female only, a few are male only. Dragon Mage, for whatever reason, is female only. The male and female versions of different classes. Actually, I kind of like that one. Yes, Parker. The male and female versions of each class are actually different. It's kind of like Disgaea, where there's slightly different skills, slightly different effects they have. Actually the male, like, regular knights have shields, but the women don't, and so the women are more attack focused. Yeah, I think I like that red. That looks best. Definitely different hair color. I'm gonna change that. Yeah, there we go. I usually color coordinate. Oh, I like that. That's good. Okay.
Perky!
There's unfortunately very limited face options. There's this face that's just eyes closed, which is kind of bad. There's this very mean looking face, which only works for certain units. It might, like, aesthetically, it work, you know, you can put it on everybody. And then there's two wide eye happy face ones. So I end up kind of using the wide eye one and this slightly aggressive one most often. And unfortunately the voice always defaults to the first voice. So for a lot of my earlier characters, I picked just the default one, not realizing that it was always the same. No. That's alright. You can also alter the pitch. Might actually put it down a little bit. Oh, and you can also use the male voices on female units. You can use the female voices on the... You can use any voice on any unit. You can name them anything. Gender is basically just visual. That's how it should be. It's a little frustrating that certain units, like... There's very few units that are entirely limited by gender. It's really just the Dragon Knight, the Mage, and the Suicide Barrel guys are male only. Mages are female only. There's two kinds of mages that are female only, actually. And there's a male only... We're actually the male version of the Dragon Knight is, like, visually it's the Dragon Knight, but you don't have the dragon. So, that kind of sucks. Let me just show you, I guess... RPGs are complicated. They're so hard to show for Let's Play stuff. I guess I'll just give you a walk through the menu and... I might do a second video of, I'll probably just do some more online. I almost forgot to mention, one complaint I do have about the online, I don't really know how long a match will last when I go into those, you know, operations. I had no idea how long that would last. I was lucky because that lasted about as long as I wanted it to. But I've gone in there and the fight is over. Oh, I guess that's the remaining time? So if I go in, I'll be in there for 21 minutes. There's different times. I don't know. I just go into them blindly because I... Let's just see if... Does this show remaining time? No, it just shows end of war. Oh, there's a timer. So that's 25. That's an hour? There's no way it lets you play for an hour and a half, does it? Oh, and you get a special reward if you get a certain number of kills in a certain operation. So if I play this again and I got 4 more kills, I get a little extra reward. So there's lots of little, you know, this game is very carrot, very little stick. So, you know, it encourages you to play online, but it doesn't, you know, really punish you too much for not doing it. And if you only play the offline, you know, the main story, you don't really need all of the extra crap. You know, you only need the online stuff to be the very best, like no one ever was. And there's also these little shorter missions that you can do that are also against NPCs from the intertubes. So it's basically the campaign and this travel thing, which are offline. Anyway, I got distracted. Let me show you my characters here. Let me show you my Pokemons. So we have your weapon, you've got your accessories. We have these, what are these things called? Pyrenes or something? It's some kind of crystal. Basically they just give you... You get lots of drops, and they're just totally random effects, so you can buff your melee skills. I like the ones that buff your actual stats. So, like... I'm not sure if this... So, like, I'll have stronger magic with this thing. This is obviously a melee unit, so she doesn't need that at all. But, so you can set up to 6 skills, 2 pages of your regular skills here, an assist, which her ground knock is just amazing. See, I've got a lot of skills. I can't equip all of them. You just have to tactically choose. You can also choose these passive support skills. Deadly blow. Ooh. She doesn't really need that, actually. Yeah, I really like this rapid recovery. It gives you an extra 5% of healing at the end of every battle. I usually take maybe... A bad battle, I'll take maybe half of my health, or, you know, losing obviously gets all of your health. But then you just take a few turns to recover. Even in a good battle, I can expect to take at least 10% from somebody, so a 5% heal is pretty significant. That increases my longevity quite a lot. So usually what I have is at least 2 regular attacks that I can spam over and over just to add up damage. Then I want some attacks that do some status effects like armor break and sometimes just a heavier hit like ground knock. Ground knock is so good, it's overpowered basically. Then I have Megaton Hammer. I just have that for area of effect. I actually don't use that barely at all. I've been sort of thinking of picking her other skills, but the blacksmith's specialty is destroying objects and draining health from objects, but I don't tend to see objects worth destroying all too often, so I just destroy people instead of objects. The rogue, their main thing is they can move a lot, like really far, and they can take out pretty much anything just with a lot of rapid hits, unless it has really good defense. And they have, like I said, I have two skills that do extra damage to leaders, so that's really nice. She just rushes in and takes down the leader if Stella doesn't take it out, my blacksmith. No, the noble's pretty standard sword swinger. I just have this crash sword that reduces armor break. Actually reduces def and MDef, and for 3 turns. And this one's based on weight, huh? The armor break from her is just 20% until the next turn. This one actually lasts for 3 turns, based I actually don't know if that increases or decreases with weight. Unfortunately, she has a passive ability that is Timeline Shuffle, which means when she gets KO'd, the enemy's timeline just gets shuffled randomly, which is almost totally useless because, for one thing, she never gets KO'd, and, well, rarely. If my Noble gets taken down, usually that means I'm gonna lose, because they always go for my Blacksmith first, and she has so much HP, if she goes down, I'm usually in major trouble. And I guess I should use Medical Bag. So this way I have two different ways to heal. She's my least fun character to use, but you kind of need healing. I don't know. If anybody out there plays, I would really love a character that can heal, but is like not almost entirely useless. Like she can deal 150 damage spare on a turn, but she just feels so boring, and I don't like having her in my party, frankly. I love her design. She's very cute. I picked the design, but it works out well, but she's just not very fun. I've tried replacing her, but for online wars, I don't like to have her in. I've tried to replace her with these my two magic users here, the Shaman and the Witch, which, oops, I meant to show you them, their statuses. Oh, I'm pressing circle instead of X. I've been playing Japanese games again. Parker is patiently listening to all of what I'm saying. He's such an attentive cat. So, Shaman and Mage are basically two different ranged mages. The Shaman has some status effects and stuff. I like my Shaman. They don't have heals. I was hoping one of them would learn a heal, but so far the only character I've had learn a heal that isn't a mage, or that isn't a medic, is the gunner, oddly enough, and he can shoot people with bullets to heal them. And the challenger, I do not like that class at all. That is actually an effective class, but basically they're suiciders, and so when their health is low, they can just throw down a barrel, blow themselves up, do major damage to everyone around them, and it's super annoying to fight against them, and they don't have longevity, so it's like, it's just a way to screw with your opponents. It's not really, in my opinion, like, it's not an effective long-term haul. Like, ugh, I just hate them. It's especially annoying when the AI uses them, because the AI doesn't actually have anything to lose, so it can just be a jerk, just for the sake of it. But, being an RPG, I didn't go over everything, but that's sort of most of the basics. You can play this game totally offline with never connecting online. I would recommend playing online, though. It's you can play the campaign first is basically how it's meant to go, I guess. But the online's pretty decent, and it's not super frustrating, and there's no hacks or anything, because you're not playing live against people, you're playing against their NPCs. So there's no elite hacksaws. Oh, and one more thing, this is on PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita. It is cross-play, so you can play. This is obviously PlayStation 4. I can play with people from PlayStation Vita, but it's not cross-save, and it's not cross-buy, I don't think. Yeah, it's not, it's cross-save is weird. Like, you have the same profile, I think, but it's not cross-buy, which is the important one. So that's a shame, but bigger titles are almost never cross-buy, so it's not unexpected, it's just a little kind of disappointing. But, don't knock things over, Parker. Yeah, that is Grand Kingdom. I'll probably do another video to show a different team of mine. That's my mostly melee team, but pretty damn effective, if I do say so myself. I'm all itchy. This is your fault, Parker. You make me itchy.